Good day, this is Jim Pytel from Columbia Gorge Community College. This is Digital Electronics 1. Today's lecture is entitled Digital and Analog Quantities, and it is sponsored by the dudes that quite literally changed the face of rock and roll, KISS. So KISS is obviously most often associated with sound, and it's a very loud sound, okay? So sound is an example of an analog value. And what we're going to try to do is compare and contrast the difference between analog signals and digital signals in this lecture. So an analog signal is something like sound or pressure or temperature. It's a naturally occurring phenomenon. And say, for example, in the case of temperature, temperature does not suddenly change from, for example, 70 degrees instantaneously to 80 degrees. It takes infinitely small variations in between. It might be a rapid rise in temperature, but it is taking small steps to get that way, okay? So if one were to plot an analog value, you'd expect a very smooth, continuous curve. Whereas a digital value, waveform might look something like what I'm about to draw here. It's a set of discrete values with an instantaneous change. Okay, so what it is, it's sampled at brief moments in time, and it's assigned a value, a very clear and discrete value that is usable by a machine. Okay, it's the same information, but it's a different format. Okay, and that's the key point. It's usable by a machine to make decisions. Because that's ultimately what digital electronics is doing. It's enabling a machine to make decisions so we can go out and rock and roll all night and party every single day, okay? So the values that a machine uses in our particular case is voltage levels. Okay, so we're applying different voltage levels and putting it into a code usable by a computer to make decisions when we're not there, okay? So, there's no sudden leaps in this analog. It's not suddenly jumping up to a value. Whereas here, you know, there's a sudden leap downwards or sudden leap upwards. Okay. So that's what's mean by discrete. Okay. Why are we changing analog to digital? Well, because there's a certain advantage. The main big four ones, digital data can be processed more efficiently. Number two, it can be transmitted more efficiently and reliably because you can error check that, okay? You can store it more compactly, which we'll go into in a little bit here. And this is the big one, is it can be reproduced with greater accuracy and clarity because noise, which I'm talking about is unwanted voltage fluctuation, doesn't affect as much, okay? And what I'm drawing here is an example. Here is an analog signal, a little bit of noise superimposed upon it. So, for example, an analog recording of music, the grooves in one of those big black CD-looking things, it's a record. It really is. It's a groove upon which a needle rides. And if there's any noise in there, you're going to hear those little cracks and pops in the music. Okay. Whereas a digital, where there's a clearly defined thing that I'm going to call zero region and a clearly defined one region, those spurious noise fluctuations, we are still clearly reading this one as a one. We are still clearly reading that as a zero. Okay, so the noise is not affecting it as much. And some people are led to think that digital systems are inherently high tech in nature. In our particular case, they are. It's presence or absence of a voltage level. It goes way, way, way earlier than that. I mean, think about a smoke signal. A smoke signal, it's smoke or no smoke. A Morse code, it's a dot or a dash. It could be neither in between. There are two states. In our particular case, there is voltage, there is not voltage. We're going to talk about what levels are defined as logical zero, i.e. false, or logical true one, based upon our current level of technology, okay? So, let's go ahead and talk about analog systems versus digital systems. So the classic example of an analog system, pretty much in every digital electronics textbook ever written, is a PA address system. So here we've got a singer that is producing analog sound waves, which are variations of pressure. They're received by a microphone, which is what's called a transducer. A transducer, it creates a voltage signal proportional to the pressure waves. So it's creating this tiny voltage signal, which is fed into an amplifier, i.e., making it louder, or excuse me, making it, in the case of voltage, higher voltage, still keeping that same time signature. And that voltage is then applied to a speaker, which is again a form of transducer. This time it's taking voltage and making it into sound or pressure waves, incredibly loud, which is the only way to listen to Kiss music, okay? So that is an analog system. And now compare and contrast a digital system. So here's a setup of our digital system. And what we've got here is our iPod or our iPhone, upon which Kiss's music is stored in a digital form, where it takes values, which I'm going to find to 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, and it's being fed into a DAC, a digital to analog converter. Okay? And from this point forward, it's really kind of analog. It's basically the exact same as this system. The advantage of this thing here is all these things that we've just discussed here previously. Whoops, let me scroll this up. It can be processed more efficiently, it can be transmitted more efficiently and reliably, it can be stored more compactly. I mean, think about this. Your iPhone or your iPod, you don't have to carry Kiss with you, as cool as that would be to hang out with those guys all the time. But they don't rock and roll all night and party every single day anymore like they did in the 70s. Chances are they're at an old folks' home right now, and they are not willing to go ahead and provide us with an analog representation of their voice. Okay? The digital representation of their music is now stored on this thing, okay? Which can be, again, sent and shared via digital data networks. And additionally, over time, that thing can be stored. So for whenever you want it, it's available. One of the ways I'd like to think about the evolution of digital electronics is very akin to the ascent of man. Think about those pictures you've always seen. Think about the fish crawling out of some primordial lake, evolving into a salamander, which evolves into a lizard, which evolves into a dinosaur. Dinosaurs get killed off, the mammals evolve into a primate, into a primitive man, and then finally this uber smart high-tech man, and then begins our slow descent into these video game playing slobs. Okay, now just we're thinking about advancing ourselves. So we're currently that high-tech man. Okay, that's what's occurring with these analog to digital conversion. Think about, way back when, if you wanted to listen to music, you had to carry a saxophone player with you or learn how to play the saxophone. And then you had those big black CD looking things. Let me just start drawing this, which are records, which is an analog recording of the sound. And then we've evolved again to a higher level of consciousness into those shiny, tiny CDs, and that's kind of the transition from analog to digital. What those CDs are is lands and pits, i.e., spots or no spots on that CD, which a computer is reading that encoded data. And then we've again evolved beyond the CD, the pinnacle of evolution, the iPhone and iPod, upon which data is easily stored and transmitted over the internet. Again, there are inherent advantages as applied right here to keeping things in a digital electronics realm as opposed to analog. Now, for example, I mean, we talk about this, the ability of a machine to read something. It's really hard for a machine to understand this It needs to have clear divisions. For example, 0 to 24 volts. It could store 9 volts. It could store 8 volts. It could store 7.1 volts. It'd be far easier to store zeros and ones and encode 7 volts, 8 volts, 24 volts. Okay. So there are inherent advantages of converting from analog to digital. And again, we can also always reconvert that back into an analog signal. Okay, this kind of concludes our intro lecture of digital and analog quantities.